PCH is a challenging road for many aspects, but one of them is beach erosion. And in this particular location, it is the angle of the waves are getting to the beach. It does makes this site more susceptible to erosion. We had a lot of wave erosion induced by high tides and by high surf during the storms. So little by little has been eroding the protection that PCH had.
Caltrans design geotechnical and geologist engineers have studied the location of this failed embankment and have determined that the rock slope protection was the preferred method of design to protect this area.
For instance, there's a study done for the maximum wave height that this location will see, and in this case it was like almost 21 feet. And so the 8-ton rocks, which takes the brunt of the force of the waves, the height of it is 21 feet. And that's the first layer of rock, so that's what's going to take the brunt of the energy of the wave, and behind it is half-ton rock. So then the half-ton rock is what's adjacent to our roadway. It may look like a jumble of rocks, but in reality, it's an engineered structure.
In order to place the rocks within the affected areas, the contractor was able to find an app, and he downloaded the app on his cell phone that pretty much told him the time of the day when the tides are low. This was the means of the contractor's schedule to be able to work around the clock, and for the most part, it was about two times per day per 24-hour period, and each time lasted about 4 hours. The contractor would come in at the low tide with his equipment, excavate a trench, and place fabric at the area that is affected, place small rocks to stabilize the fabrics, and haul in the big rocks during this 4 hour period within the affected area.
It is my understanding that the decision to use rock slope protection is to account for small movements, natural movements of the existing slope, where if a rigid system was used, it could potentially damage it and weaken the structure. The rock slope protection is a dynamic system which can absorb the movement of the existing conditions.
The neighbors, again, are very, very happy because they were very concerned of a total breakdown of this link between Ventura County and Los Angeles County if we do at the end lose that highway. I personally have learned a lot just kind of being involved on the project. We were again very fortunate to have a good contractor on board. The design concept was a concept to me. I've never seen it implemented. But it actually all came in place. Environmental people were also very proactive in allowing us some changes and giving us the approval from all the different agencies that are involved with the permit requirements.